So we're now going to take a look at the balloon lemma, just its statement, and an immediate consequence of it. So the balloon lemma, this is not a standard name, but it's quite covering. It says the following. So suppose Cn is an increasing sequence, and this means that Cn plus 1 is bigger than Cn for every n. Okay, so the terms get bigger and bigger and bigger. You could put strict inequality here if you want. In terms of the result, it's true in either case. Okay, so strict or non-strict doesn't really matter. Then we have two options. One of the two following statements hold. So one is that there exists a number m in the in the real numbers such that the Cn are smaller than or equal to m for every n that's in the index set of Cn. So from 1 to infinity, whatever. Maybe natural numbers would be good here, but let's leave that unsaid. So this basically just means that the Cn's are bounded above. And in this case, there exists a number L such that the Cn's converge to L as n tends to infinity. So this statement may seem a little bit strange, but it basically gives us a recipe for how to prove that something converges without knowing explicitly what it's supposed to converge to. So if we have an increasing sequence, something looking like this, and we know that there is some number, maybe a million, that it definitely doesn't pass, then we get from this result that there is some L, perhaps a bit lower than M or perhaps equal to M, we don't know, such that the sequence tends towards L as n goes to infinity. Why do I call this balloon lemma? Well, we're coming to part two soon, but the point is that if a kid is inside of a house, maybe 4 meters is the height of the house when measured from the outside. If he drops his balloon, then we know that, okay, if this is a helium balloon, then we know that the balloon will go up, up, up. It will not, if it doesn't exit the house, then there's an upper bound to how high it can go, which means that its altitude will stabilize, its height will stabilize. Okay, maybe it stabilizes, maybe the inside roof is a bit lower, who knows? In that case, it stabilizes at a bit lower height than this M, but who cares? The conclusion is that it will stabilize at some height. But what's part two? Well, part two is there exists no M as above, so it's not bounded above. In this case, Cn goes to plus infinity as n goes to infinity. So we just have two options here. Either you're bounded and you converge, or you're not bounded and then you diverge to infinity. And this is when we're talking about increasing sequences. This means that increasing sequences can't behave in any weird way, such as, you know, the limit of n goes to infinity of minus 1 to the n, which diverges, but it does so because it can't decide on the height. It doesn't diverge to infinity, okay? Now, basically, this statement here is just a bunch of common sense. But when we look at its proof, we'll see that we actually need the completeness axiom to prove it, which sort of gives it a little bit of respect. This is connected to the completeness property of the real numbers. So let us now look at consequence of the balloon lemma. And it's a consequence for positive series. So let's do here proposition. And this proposition says that positive series behave really nice. But what is a positive series? Well, a positive series is a series with only positive terms. So suppose sum ak, k goes from 0 to infinity, is positive, or is a positive series, i.e. ak bigger than 0 for every k, then one of the following two statements must hold. So what are they? Well, the first is that, well, what? So what's the connection up here? So the connection is that if I view my partial sums here as n, then they are ak summed from k is 0 to n. Thing is that if this guy here is always positive, then what can I say about my Sn? Well, every time I add another term here, my Sn will either stay the same or grow. So my Sn satisfies this inequality here. So the Sn is a growing sequence. So I can actually apply the balloon lemma directly to the Sn's, the partial sums of a positive series. And then I immediately get the same thing here, except for this guy. So if I have a positive series, then well, one, either there exists an m in R such that the partial sums are less than m for every n, and in this case, this guy converges, right? The infinite series converges. Or two, there is no such m. And this infinite series here diverges to infinity. And we get this. So you can say either, so for positive series, either you converge or you diverge to infinity. And this is different than, for instance, the Grandi series that we have seen in the course, which looks like this. So he is divergent, but he does not diverge to infinity. And this can happen because the terms are both positive and negative. If we have only positive terms, such a thing cannot happen. This is the important part, or the important message from this proposition. So for this reason, when we talk about positive series, so series with only positive terms, instead of saying that something converges, we might as well say that it's finite. So if we have a positive series, it's either finite and convergent, or it's infinite and divergent. We don't have to deal with weird behavior such as this. So for this reason, these two symbols are used quite a lot when we sum positive things, and we will for the most part sum positive terms.